Hello everyone, I am going to explain question number 7 from exercise 3.4 from 11th class maths. So question number 7th is, find the general solution for each of the following equation. So today I am teaching question number 7. In question number 7, the given trigonometric equation is sine 2x plus cos x is equal to 0. So students, here we just observe the angle properly. Here the angle is 2x and here is only x. So first we are going to split this sine 2x in simplest form. So I am going to use the formula of sine 2x. So we will start the solution. Here given equation is sine 2x plus cos x is equal to 0. So as I told you, I am going to use sine 2x formula. Sine 2x formula is 2 sine x cos x plus cos x is equal to 0. So this is the formula of sine 2x which I used. After using the formula, we found that cos x is common in both the terms. So just take cos x common. After taking cos x common, here you will obtain, you will remain with only 2 sine x. And here we are going to remain with 1. So the product of cos x and this bracket is equal to 0. So conclusion is either cos x is equal to 0 or this bracket is equal to 0. So one by one, both the cases we have to take. So case first, when cos x is equal to 0. So students, direct you have a formula that if cos x is equal to 0, then x is equal to, so cos is 0 at pi by 2, so its formula is 2n plus 1 pi by 2. So it's a direct formula which you have to learn, and here n belongs to z. So after using this formula, we will get here, which implies x is equal to 2n plus 1 multiplied by pi by 2, where n belongs to set of integers, that is z. So first case completed. So this is the general solution we obtained from the case first. Now we will do case second. In case second, we have when 2 sine x plus 1 equal to 0. So in this situation, we need only sin x, so we are going to shift this 1 and 2 in other side. So we will obtain I am writing the again the bracket. So in bracket we have 2 sin x plus 1 equal to 0. So when we shift this 1 and 2 in other side, we are going to obtain sin x is equal to minus 1 upon 2. So students, here we got, since we got here minus half, that's why we have to think that at which minimum angle sin is minus half. So for it, first the quadrant concept is very important. So students, you already know the quadrants. So there are 4 quadrants: first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. And since here we have sine, and we know that sine is positive in first and second quadrant, and it's negative in third and fourth quadrant. So negative, it is negative in third and fourth quadrant. So in these two quadrants we have to search the angles. So first we have to think that sine x is equal to half at which angle. So from 10th class concept, we know that sine half is at 30 degree. 30 degree means sine pi by 6, because in radian, in degree measure it's 30 degree, and in radian measure pi upon 6. Pi means 180 here. So pi means 180. So 180 upon 6 is 30 degrees. So pi upon 6. So at pi upon 6 it's positive half, but we need the negative half. So we have to move in this quadrant. So we have to do pi plus pi upon 6. And the other value is 2 pi minus pi upon 6. Among them the minimum one is this one. So we are going to select this angle. I hope it's clear. We need sine at which angle is minus half. So students, first we have to think that sine is negative in which quadrants. That will give you answer that it is negative in third quadrant and at fourth quadrant. Now, since here we have minus half, so first you just think for the half, positive half. For positive half, your answer is pi upon 6. Because we need negative half, that's why now you just do pi plus pi upon 6. So you will move in the, because here we have pi. We need to move third quadrant, that's why just do pi plus pi upon 6. So when we'll do, so here we are going to replace it. So it's going to be sine x is equal to sine pi plus pi upon 6. We are going to take LCM. So when we take LCM, we are going to get sine x is equal to, when we take LCM is going to be 6 pi plus 1 is 7 pi upon 6. Now we are going to write down the formula for it. So the formula is, since sine x is equal to sine y implies that x is equal to n pi plus minus 1 to the power n y. So it's a formula for this equation. That's why for our given equation, that is sine x is equal to sine 7 pi upon 6, the value of general solution is going to be x is equal to n pi plus minus 1 power n y. So instead of y, what we have here, 7 pi upon 6. So the y we are going to replace. Instead of y, the angle is 7 pi upon 6. So both the cases we saw. Now we'll write down final answer. Hence, the general solution for given equation is, so two answers we obtained. From case first, we obtained x is equal to 2n plus 1 pi upon 2, and from case second we obtained x is equal to n pi plus minus 1 power n, then 7 pi upon 6. And what is n here? N belongs to z, set of integers. So this is belongs to, so n belongs to z. So it's completed. So students, I hope this question is clear to you. So this is a rough work. So we'll write here rough work. I hope for both the cases are clear to you. Further, if you have any doubt, you can write in comment so that I can clear out your doubts. Thank you.